السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Wherever you are, whenever you are, today we'll talk about another lesson learned from the bread riots in Egypt in 1977, 18 and 19 January 1977. At that time, there was a pressure from the World Bank and the International Monetary Fund on Egypt to remove the support on the commodities, especially bread and others, and oil and gas and. This created a big riot. Hundreds of thousands of people came to the streets of Cairo and other cities and destroying buildings, burning buses and burning cars. And yeah, it was actually very, very bad. And there was a curfew at that. At that time, I was a house officer in a teaching hospital called Sayyid Jalal Hospital in an area called Bab al-Sha'riyya. The distance between my house the hospital more than 10 kilometers plus, and I have to walk it at that time. So I came out after having my shower. Of course, I was very handsome at that time and good looking, as people might consider. And I was wearing a very handsome dress, black suit with underneath it a yellow shirt with a high collar, with a Persil glass, which is dark glass, which is a fashionable one from Italy, with a mustache, and I was so clean to be met with those demonstrators. So I went from my house to Mahrousa Street, from Mahrousa Street to Ahmed Arab Street, then crossing the Malik Bridge, from the Malik Bridge going to the Malik area. From the Malik area, I went to Abu al-Ila or Bulaq area. Bulaq area is a very, very overcrowded area and very popular area. And there I saw the impact and the effect of this demonstration on the cars, on the buses, on the buildings, and. And I found some of those young people, young children, are actually breaking the windows of what you call it, a cigarette glass cases or cigarette windows, which were next to the sugarcane juice shop or the fruit juice shop. And I was trying to be boiling and angry. And when I become angry, I cannot control myself. So a few meters, or maybe 100 or 200 meters after that, I found the same crowd throwing stones at one of the electricity buildings and breaking all the glasses. I couldn't be able to tolerate that. Understood, forgetting how I look, and they'd be seeing somebody like myself, and telling them, young men and young men, you know what you are doing? You are destroying the building which belongs to you. This is your building. Why are you breaking the glasses? You know what they said? He is one of them. He is one of them. Because I was stereotyped by them as a security man in a civilian clothes. And within few seconds, I found tens of young people running, rushing towards me. I am somebody who cannot run at a time of conflict. I was just there standing, waiting for my fate, and they did not know what to do. Within few seconds, I found four or five very well-built, strong young men, tall. They came, surrounded me in a semicircle, told me, you go from this avenue, don't look back. Don't look back, keep going. And they went to confront the trousers, telling them, yeah, he's a bad man. We swear that him, he is one of those bad people in this area. So both sides thought that I am a part of them. The demonstrators thought I'm a part of the security because of the way I looked, clean, shaved, mustache, glasses, dark glasses, suit. And the security men in civilian clothes thought that I'm an officer as well, not wearing my actually uniform. Allah saved me. But lesson learned here from what? When you are demonstrating, what is that to do with this cigarette glass case, which owned by a very poor man? Its capital is less than 100 pounds. He might make out of it 2, 3, or 4 pounds a day to have one meal or two meals with him and his family. This is something which makes me angry. The second one, you are destroying the building which you built. It is your building. It is the people's building. It belongs to the people. Why are you destroying it? Actually, whenever you come to a demonstration, also, if you have a problem with the government, don't destroy the building that you are paying the tax to be rebuilt again. And this is where I was actually nearly lost my life in this fight, because during these riots, nobody will know who killed you. Nobody will know who broke your back or broke your leg or broke your arm or broke your neck. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.